Elb, quick, look at her cute and say so quirk. For the bicker she lives, the slicker she grows. Save us and take us. No more? Where on earth did you ever pick a lambay chop as big as a battering ram? Ah, you're right. I'm up to forgetting. Like Livium Little did love me long. The length of my hock, I say. She wore a ploughboy's nail-studded clogs. A pair of ploughfields in themselves. A sugarloaf hat with a gaudy quivery peak. And a band of gorse for an ornament, and 100 streamers dancing off it, and a gilded pin to pierce it. Owl glassy bicycles boggled her eyes, and a fishnet's veil for the sun not to spoil the wrinklings of her hide aspects. Potato rings buckled the loose lobes of her loud snarers. Her nude Cuba stockings were salmon spot speckled. She sported a galago shimmy of hazy vapor tinto. That never was fast till it ran in the washing. Stout stays, the rivals lined her length. Her blood orange buck knickers, a two-in-one garment, showed natural niggerbockers, fancy fastened, free to undo. Her black striped tan Joseph was sequin sewn and teddy bear lined, with wavy rush green epaulettes and a lead down here and there of royal swan's ruff. A brace of gaspers stuck in her hay rope garters. Her civvy corduroy coat with alphabet buttons was boundaried round with a two-bar tunnel belt. A fourpenny bit in each pocket side weighed her safe from the blow-away windrush. She had a clothes peg tight astride on her jockey's nose, and she kept on grinding as something quaint in her fumy mouth, and the reek of the fluve of the tail of the gowan of her snuff-drab sewler skirt trailed 50-odd Irish miles behind her longer hoods. Hell's bells, I'm sorry I missed her. Sweet gumpty arm, and nobody fainted. But in folk of her mouths was her nasolite. Everyone that saw her said the douce little Delia looked a bit queer. Lotsy Trotsy, mind the puddle. Missus be good and don't fall in the say. Fenny per hex she must have charred. Kickums of frumpier ever you saw, making mush mullet's eyes at her boy's Dublin. And they crowned her their Cheriton queen, all the maids. Off the May, you don't say. Well for her, she couldn't see herself. I reckon it's wherefore the darling murried her mirror. She did, mercy me. There was a chorus of drouth-drobbing sir.